All right, ladies and gentlemen.
No, no.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
You're not hot, man.
My name.
I know you're
hot. No, I'm not hot. It's Brother John.
Brother John.
That's my name.
That's a full name.
That's a full name?
Yes. That's my professional name, Brother John, because I'm a motivational speaker and mentor.
Thought that was your ice
profession. How are you? Okay, it's an honor to be here at the Bronx High School for Writing and Communication Arts. This is not my first time here. This is my fourth year in a row. And I'm a native from the Bronx. I grew up in Carp City, Section 5. And I'm an original hip-hop kid from the 80s. The culture of hip-hop started, you know, of course, in the Bronx. And I was part of that right here in the Bronx, Section 5, all of Carp City, the Valley, Gun Hill. This is my neighborhood. I'm happy to be here, and I didn't attend this school. I actually went to school in Clark City, but I was a part of this community, and I would come around this school because back then, unfortunately, in my prior life, I was a criminal. So I'm going to talk to you this morning about two different parts of my life. I had a criminal career, and I have now a professional career. If you read my bio and chose to be a part of this segment, then you know what my story is. Anybody have any questions before we begin? Okay. You have a question?
What you mean, like, you say by criminal, like, you did back in
the day? Say that
again? Like, you meant by criminal, you did back in the day.
Yes, I made bad choices. And it took me years to realize, I see your hand, that I'm not a bad person. I just made some very bad decisions. Like yourself, when I was 15, 16, 17, 18, in high school, I did not see where I fit into society. I did not know what I wanted to do with myself. I was a part of, we didn't call it gang activity then, but we were just from different communities or different hoods, and we were at war with each other over nonsense. We would go to parties to have a good time, and we would end up with a shootout. We would end up with stabbings and violence. And that was part of what it was to be in school for me back then. I didn't necessarily agree with the curriculum. I didn't agree with all that was given to me in school. Some of the things that were given to us did not connect with me. So I had an issue with being in school. I had an issue growing up. It was peer pressure and all of the stuff that you're going through right now. For me, I chose, rather than go to college, to be a drug dealer. And unfortunately, that led to violence, and it led me to do 17 years in prison. 17 years in prison.
Damn.
Yes. Oh. And upon release, I started a brand new life. So I made some really bad decisions. I had an opportunity to go to college. I had an opportunity to have a thriving career when I was 22 years old, working for a law firm. But instead, I wanted to be a drug dealer and make bad decisions. I wanted to be violent and make bad decisions. And it cost me my life. So what happened is a career and criminality rewarded me with a retirement plan in prison. And I'm smiling as I'm saying it sarcastic. So if you want free dental, free medical, free room and board, a workout exercise facility, that's the choice that you can make. And I'm saying it sarcastic and you're laughing because the reality of it is not funny, it's actually very sad. There are buildings being produced, institutions being built, to house every one of you right now. It's actually on the stock market. Now you can choose that as a career for yourself, or you can make a smart decision and do something different. I didn't come to tell you that you can go to prison and come home and be okay like Brother John. No, I came to tell you that you are good people, you just make some bad decisions sometimes, and it's time to make better decisions, all right? Now let's look at the word career. We have a career, and we have a job. Anybody know the difference? What's the difference, John?
So the difference is that a job is like short term, and a career is like what you want to do like for the rest of your life.
Okay. Very good. Who else had the hand?
All right, career.
No, somebody over here had the hand. You, then you.
I said career is something.
Speak up.
I said career is something.
Long term and extra money. Yeah.
For me, career is something you business, and you know you can't get fired from that job, you could get fired from that a job.
Okay, not necessarily, but okay. So what we want to do is look at it, right? A career is something, yes, it's long term. In the word career, you have the word car, right? Which involves transportation or motion or movement. You also have the word care. A career is just something that you're passionate about, something that you really want to do. A job is just punching a clock for money. And you can punch a clock just for money, or you can find a thriving opportunity that allows you to exercise your gifts, thank you, that allows you to exercise your gifts, your talents, your desires, your passion, what you enjoy, or you can just punch somebody's clock for the rest of your life and not be happy. Having a career, you can be an entrepreneur and have your own business, or you can work for someone else. But if you enjoy doing it, it's something that's long-term and long-lasting. Jobs come and go. You may work at McDonald's, that's just working your job. And I'm not knocking anyone who works at McDonald's, because we all have to start out somewhere. But when I was younger, in your age, we worked at McDonald's. Nowadays, when I returned from doing my 17 years, I observed that now there's an older population working at McDonald's. And these people are not happy. They have to do what they have to do in order to survive. But we don't want to just survive, we want to learn how to live. And there's a difference between survival and living. So, career is living oriented. Just having a job is kind of survival oriented. How many of you want to live rather than survive? By show of hands.
Live.
Okay. So, even our teacher in the back raised her hand. And let me tell you, teaching is a career. If you're passionate about it, at the very root, I'm a teacher. Yes, I'm a motivational speaker. Yes, I'm a mentor. Yes, I own a business for beauty bundles and women's hair. Yes, I'm a partner in a publishing company. And yes, I have a job working for a company called VIP, in which I go all over New York City and I teach public health, HIV, hepatitis, STIs. I test people, I do workshops, I credentialize people with my partners, and we service people. But that's my job. My career, my passion is doing what I'm doing now. Inspiring, motivating, educating, and at the root, I'm a teacher. I believe that teachers, I got you, are the most underpaid, are the most underpaid profession. An athlete can get millions of dollars, but an athlete does not shape the minds of future leaders. And I want you to think with me. How many of you remember your first grade teacher? How many of you remember your second grade teacher? Third grade teacher. Fourth grade teacher. We can keep going because they made an impact in your life. There's nothing greater than being a teacher. And I'm not trying to push you or motivate you to be a teacher, but I want you to value every person that teaches you something. I think my philosophy is that the key to immortality is to be a teacher. Because if you can plant a seed in someone and let it grow, you'll live forever because they'll always remember you. A lot of us want to be remembered in the hood for doing dumb stuff, for making poor decisions. We want to rep. We want the good name. But the good name, a good name is better than gold. If you really want to get the good name, find out why you're here. What your gift is, dig down deep within and pull it out, and then give it back to society, and you will live forever. You'll be able to set up something beyond just your career. Your career will leave a mark that when you're gone, whatever you created will still remain. How many would like to have a life like that? Okay, so this is career day. This is not job day, it's career day. So we want to motivate you, the youth, which we call the Joshua generation, or millennials, if you will. And you're not strange, you're not different. You're the same way I was when I was young. The only difference between you and I is that I'm just a little older. I was running these streets before you, or I was going to school before you did. But again, you have the opportunity to make better decisions than I made. Now, I came home at 40 years old, entered into a job market at 40, and I had to compete with 22-year-olds just coming out of college during the recession. So I had to figure out where I fit. Once again, being 22 and 18 is different from being 40. And at 40, I had to come home and figure out where I fit. You don't have to do that. You have the opportunity right now to absorb as much information as you can to make a career choice. Again, in the word career, you have the word car, which represents motion. Job represents standing still. So we have mobile, we have immobile. And if you just pay attention to some elders in your community, some grown-ups in your community, and you look, and you interview, and you ask questions, are you happy? Don't be sarcastic, of course, always approach them with respect. But ask them, are they happy doing what they do? And you'll see the difference. You'll hear the difference. How many want to be an entrepreneur?
Huh?
How many of you want to be an entrepreneur?
Something like that.
Okay. What are you interested in? What do you want to do? Huh? You're not sure? That's okay. That's a good place to be. You're not sure. And it's okay not to be sure. How about you?
Music.
Music. What about music?
All right. I want to own my own record label someday.
You want to own your own record label someday? What kind of music?
Rap,
hip hop, maybe some reggae.
No
reggae.
I can't do that part.
You can't do that part. Okay.
I don't like it.
Okay.
I live it.
So let's stay focused. Let's stay focused. What else do you want
to do? I want to go to the army.
You want to go into the army? Why?
Ever since I was a little kid, it was a little dream that I wanted.
You want to go into the army?
Be reminded to stay in class. This session is not over until 10:30. Thank you.
Is there a reason why you want to go into the army?
I want to be the sixth person in my family to go to the army.
So you're doing this for your family, not? Is this something you want to do for you?
It's always been like that, but I recently found out that if I'm going, I'm going to be the sixth person in my family to go to the army.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's noble. But just remember that nobility is good, but make sure it's something that you want to do for you.
It is something that I want to do for
you. Okay. How about you, young man? Do you see yourselves or your life beyond entertainment, beyond sports? Could you see yourself owning a business? Could you see yourself being an architect, being an engineer, constructing one of these buildings that you see out here? Could you see that for yourself? No?
Yeah, but for me to build one of these buildings, I could do the blueprint, but I end up working at IED.
Okay, you could do the blueprint. That's good. Don't limit yourself. And when you approach these subjects like biology, like chemistry, try to see yourself in it. Try to see yourself in it. Because you're more than just being a basketball player or being on a reality show or being an actor. You're more than that. You are biology, you are chemistry, you are science, you are mathematics, and you have to be able to see it. And as I'm looking around the room, in case no one told you, you come from a great heritage of builders. Anybody ever see pyramids? You come from a lineage that built that, which they still can't figure out how to build. So never limit yourself, okay? You can do anything that you want to do. Anybody know what a vision board is? Okay, good. You know what, someone?
Based on what you just said, like, vision board, like,
goals you want, you put goals that you want to avoid.
Okay. This is the High School for Writing and Communication Arts, correct? Okay, so here's an assignment for you that will help you to get a career and not just a job. I want you to go home and create a vision board. You can get a piece of paper like this, put it in your room, and whatever you want, I want you to put it on that piece of paper. If you cut out something from a magazine, if it's a particular car you want, if it's a particular house you want, if it's a particular lifestyle you want, if it's the image of a particular husband or wife that you want, a vision of a family, whatever, if it's a degree, whatever it is that you want, I want you to put it on that piece of paper, I want you to look at it every day, visualize it, and believe that you actually can achieve it. Second, I want you to write your history in advance. Get a piece of paper.
Please stop this interruption. Seniors were just released from a presentation, so they will be interrupting classes. We apologize for that. Also, any student who has room 218 on their schedule, please report to room 212, the science lab. If you have 218 on your schedule, please report to room 212, the science lab. Thank you.
So, as we wrap this up, you have the ability to write your history in advance and then walk into what you visualize. Everything that I'm doing right now, from speaking in this high school, I wrote down when I was in prison. I projected for myself what I wanted to do with the rest of my life, because I did not want that to be the rest of my life. I own two businesses, I have a job, so I'm eating three different ways. I have three different rivers coming into my garden of Eden, if you will. Okay? I drive a brand new BMW, and I'm not saying that to be a materialist, but I'm saying that because I know you like nice things, and you're attracted to flashy things and nice things. You can get nice things, but you don't have to sell drugs. You can work hard if you want those things. You can live in a home rather than an apartment. If you work hard, you can get that.
Work hard, pay
hard. So some people will tell you, you can only get those things by selling drugs, standing on the corner or doing something bad, running up in a bank or doing something that can get cost you your life or cost you a life in prison, which is no life at all. I'm here to tell you, all you have to do is visualize and connect with the right people, and you can achieve anything that you want. All right? Anybody have any questions? Anybody have any dreams? What do you want to do? You've been writing since I've been speaking. What do you want to do?
I'm an international
criminal lawyer. Wow, that's huge. And I commend you. Give her a round of applause. That's huge. See? And her shirt says, Petty Queen. Why petty? How about just queen? Okay, take the petty off. Queen. 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 Not B-I-T-C-H, fellas. Queen. 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 I'm sorry, queen. King. 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 We got a little prince over there in the back. Okay? All right? The teacher, queen. Respect each other.
Right.
Respect ourselves. It's important. Perspective is important. And if you don't respect yourself, nobody else will. When you get up in the morning, I want you to look at yourself in the mirror and say, queen. I want you to say, king. Because this world has a way of putting its foot on your neck and making you feel less than. And that's how I was when I was young. I felt less than. I didn't know where I fit in. People were cruel. They snap on you. They make fun of you and all kinds of stuff. And that can turn you into a monster. You okay back there, big brother?
He's speaking.
Okay. Does he, what language does he speak?
Spanish.
Hola. Un poquito. Just a little bit. But you understand, right? Comprende? A little bit? Does anybody else speak Spanish? Nobody? You do? So I want you to help me out and translate whatever you understood today and share it with him, because we don't want him to miss anything. All right? And that that's another thing. Somebody's a little different. We laugh at them. Help them out. Help them out. It's important to help them out. As a community, as a village, as a tribe, as a family, you gotta help each other. It's not putting each other down. It's important. There's so much out there. And this world is a fix-it society. You can get a new this or a new that, or you can improve this or improve that. And it kind of makes you feel like there's something wrong with the natural you. There's nothing wrong with you. And you're not a problem that has to be fixed. You are growing, young ladies and men, and you are gonna grow into productive, positive people that hopefully will make an impact on this society. You guys are the future. You'll be running this country when your teacher and myself will be old. So we trust you with our future. But you have to trust us to guide you into a better future. Don't you want a better future for yourself?
Yeah. Okay.
So we gotta get serious. School cannot be a place to play. And either you're a visitor or you're a student. How many of us are students? How many of us are visitors? Okay. Right. I'm the visitor. That's right. Not you. You're the student. So let's get into student mode and take it serious because you only got one shot at this. And you know. You know the sound that comes to your hood? Woo-hoo. They are waiting to take you away. And they have a bed. And a cell for you and for your children. And I'm not trying to scare you, I'm just being real. That doesn't have to be an option for your life. You can do whatever you want to do. I just came to motivate you and tell you that you can have those things. It really is not about me. It's more about you. Question, what made you select? Because I understand that they read through your bio and select who they want to
select. But did you even really exactly the class?
What explain, what did you say?
I take a survey and they check off the ones that they would want to see. And then they try to fit everyone in.
Okay.
I think they would probably like it.
Well, you're going to see some of those guys. And you're going to see them. There's three different segments. And you'll see them. They'll be coming in shortly. So do you guys stay here or do you move?
They move.
They move and a new move comes in. Okay, excellent.
But it's okay that things are different. You should broaden your horizon.
Yes. And you know why they used to give me my own classroom? This is my fourth year in a row. This is my fourth year in a row. Because of my story and the impact that I've made on some of the students in this high school last year, the year before that, I usually get my own classroom. Everybody else has to share because of the importance of the message. So I didn't want to shock you. I know you looked a little like, whoa, at first. But it's important for you to know, because sometimes in life, we have a downward growth at first. When you plant a seed into the ground, that seed swells, and then it bursts. And when it bursts, there's a downward growth. A shaft comes out and grows down and roots it. And then it grows up into a flower. And sometimes that's how it is for us. So you may feel like this is a down period for you, right? For me, prison was a down period. That doesn't have to be yours. This could be your down period right now where you just can't figure out, you know, where you fit into society. Why do I have to go to school? How many of you are tired of school, honestly? You're not gonna get in trouble. You really are tired of school? What are you tired about?
Every day.
Is it the demands?
Yeah, most of the time.
How many of you love school?
I love school, bro. Okay.
Why do you love school?
I love school because I like to learn.
Okay. How about you? Learning new stuff every day. Anybody else? Yeah, between. I was there. I get it. Same with you? Same with you?
I need to talk to
you. You love the gym. Okay. That's honest. That's honest. And again, there's no right or wrong. Questions and answers. But the thing is, for those of you who love learning, you don't have to limit your learning to this building. Pick up a book. Go to the library. Go to YouTube. Go to the internet. Anything you want to learn about, Look it up. Study it. Right? Don't limit yourself just to coming here to learn. You can learn something every day. How about you?
It's like some of this subject.
It doesn't connect.
No, I like social.
What subject don't you like? You hate math? Why?
The number of boys? Because they mix up and then everything just like connect.
You know what math is? Math is solving problems. Solving problems. And if you could probably look at it a little differently, you might begin to like math. Try to do some research. Go to YouTube and look at alternative ways to learn math and see what you find. See if you can kind of catch it from a different perspective that's more relatable to you. And if you have an issue with learning something, don't sit down and not say anything. Your teachers are here to help you. So pull them to the side and say, listen, I'm not quite getting this. Can you make the subject more relatable to me? Right? I remember being in school where Dick and Jane went up the hill with three apples and they wanted to know how many did they come down. It just wasn't relatable to me.
Yeah.
It wasn't. Yeah. And I'm not saying that you have to put it in some ghetto scenario from the hood either, but if it's made relevant to you and you see yourself in it, then it makes it more interesting. But there's always alternative ways that people learn differently. Some people learn through visual, some people learn from memory, some people learn differently. And there's different strategies, and we're not here to criticize the teacher, of course.
Good morning, everyone. We're going to transition. This is your 5-minute
warning. And you guys, 5-minute
warning.
You got 5 more minutes.
Wait, right now. Those are 5-minute
warnings. Everybody remember what a vision board is?
No,
whatever. So, we have 5 minutes. Vision board, you know what it is? Vision board. Writing your history in advance. Okay. How many are going to actually do the assignment that I just gave you? Excellent. How many of you learned something today? Excellent. What did you learn? Come on, we got 5 minutes. What did you learn, Queen?
I learned to be what you want.
Be what you want.
Be what you love.
Mm-hmm. What did you learn? How about you?
Yeah.
What you know?
You must not limit yourself to nothing.
Not limit yourself to nothing.
What I mean.
I learned all the ages said things all took my
mind. Took your answer. Anybody else want to add to that? You? Brother Evan back? Yes?
I learned that a career is like something that you want to do.
Yes. One last question. How many of you feel motivated today? Excellent, and I did my job. I'm happy. You have a wonderful rest of the day. Congratulations.